Let's get a volume for this interesting shape by using shells. So this is made out of the region bounded by this little exponential curve. That's the one on the bottom. Y equals 2e to the negative x. Y equals 1 for the upper boundary. X equals 3 for the right boundary. And I want to use nested cylindrical shells for this, and that requires that I use shells that have the same symmetry axis as the solid of evolution that I'm looking at. So I'm going to do all these nested shells like this, and they have a little bit of thickness which I can view easiest along their horizontal sides. And I can make some attempt to draw the thickness of the shell on the end of the shell, but it's a little bit tricky to get that done. That's probably good enough. And then I noticed that the thickness of this thing is dy. And that immediately tells me I'm going to be doing a y integral when I add all of these little shells up. I need to get the volume of one of these shells. I'm going to need to get the radius of the shell. And that's the distance here from y equals 1 down to whatever the y coordinate is of the bottom edge of this thing. So my plan is to identify each of these shells by that y coordinate and then add them all up as I go from the minimum value of y all the way up to y equals 1, where I have really skinny, longer shells. So one of the really tricky things about this problem is I've got to figure out the length of these shells. And that's a horizontal distance between x equals 3 and then the x value corresponding to that y. So we've got to take that y coordinate and we've got to invert and go back to the x coordinate that it came from. So just as a little side note here, I had the curve y equals 2e to the negative x, and I need to solve this for x in order to figure out what that x coordinate is connected to this y coordinate. So I'm going to divide by 2, take the natural log of both sides, solve for x, and I get that x is negative natural log y over 2. You can play with this a little, you don't have to, but if I had the reciprocal of that interior, so this would be 2 over y to the negative 1, and I could bring out the negative 1 using log properties. So I could write this as positive natural log 2 over y. There's not a lot of benefit to that, but I thought I would mention it. All right, so this x coordinate is natural log 2 over y, and then my y coordinate again is used to identify which shell that I'm talking about here. So the width of the shell is going to be 3 minus natural log 2 over y. Okay, so now I'm ready to do a cut. I'm just going to slice my shell and unroll it, and then I should be able to express the amount of volume in that shell. So here's my unrolled shell. I'm just going to unroll it vertically, just the way it was oriented. And it has a little bit of thickness. Remember, the thickness from the diagram was dy. This whole thing has a differential volume of dv. And this width here, that was 3 minus natural log 2 over y. And then the height of this slab, well, that's the circumference of the old shell when it was rolled up. So that's where I'm going to end up using my radius, which I think I said was 1 minus y, but didn't write. So that the circumference of the shell, again, is equal to this height of the slab when I unroll the shell. So that circumference is 2 pi times the radius. 2 pi times the quantity 1 minus y. And now I just use simple geometry to say what the volume of the shell is. Length times width times height. So I have dv equals 2 pi times the quantity 1 minus y times 3 minus natural log of 2 over y times the thickness dy. And I'm done setting up my integral. Basically, v is the sum of all the dv's. Oh, I have one more complication coming up, and I have 2 pi integral 1 minus y times the quantity 3 minus natural log of 2 over y dy. The complication that I just realized is that my starting y value, that's all the way over here, has to be determined algebraically, and then my finishing y value is 1, so I'll put that in. We'll see what my starting y value is. We'll just call it like y1 to make it easy to reference. Well, that's just the value of this curve, 2e to the negative x, evaluated at x equals 3. So that's 2e to the negative 3. And there we have it.